morning everyone. Today we will discuss about our new topic is IoT, okay, Internet of Things. This technology is nowadays booming technology in entire world. So let's get started this introduction of IoT. Before we going for this one, we must know about the basic fundamental of embedded systems. So what is meant by embedded systems? What are the components of embedded systems? What are the software's requirement for the embedded systems? Let us, we have to discuss about these topics. So by the name itself, IoT is nothing but it is Internet of Things. So let us discuss about the embedded systems. Embedded systems. So generally, embedded system is a combination of hardware and software. Okay, it is nothing but embedded system is a combination of hardware and software which makes dedicated for specified application. Nothing but we have to use for the only one application we can developing the embedded system. But embedded system will be combining the hardware as well as the software components. So let us discuss about the what are the main blocks of embedded systems. So the main block diagram of embedded system is the first one is sensor. So second one is A to D converter, and third one is microprocessor or microcontroller, anyone. So next one is DTA converter, and next one is actuator. So in this microprocessor and microcontroller, we have to require the memory. So this is the very important. So this is the memory. This is the bidirectional. Here memory, we have to consider the RAM and ROM. RAM and ROM, random access memory, read only memory. So this is the general block diagram of embedded system. So externally we have to give the, this one is the power supply. This is the general block diagram of embedded systems. In this block diagram it will be consisting of the hardware and software components. Let us discuss each one. So this is the sensor, this is A to D converter, analog to digital converter, and microprocessor or microcontroller, we have to take any one. And next one is the DTA converter, it is nothing but digital to analog converter. So next one is the actuator. So actuator is nothing but finally we can get the output. So all those components will be working on the power supply. This is the very important. Without power supply, your device is properly not working. So in that case, we have to go for the power supply is connected to the all those devices. So here, what are the hardware devices, what are the software devices, will be discussed here. So what are the hardware devices? Nothing but sensor. So sensor is nothing but here we have to take the different types of sensors, like that pressure sensors will be there. So suppose we have to find the pressure value. Otherwise, suppose we have to find the temperature value. How to find the temperature value? How to find the pressure value? By using your microprocessor. So in that case, we have to go for the sensors is there. Every sensor will be having the analog parameters. So that sensor is given to the A to D converter. Our concept is that your microprocessor or microcontroller will be take the digital values. So in that case, we have to go for the A to D converter in between sensor to microcontroller, because of A to D is nothing but analog to digital converters. So whatever the analog parameters will be there, that will be converted to the digital value. So in that case, we have to go for the A to D converter, then it will be given to the microcontroller or microprocessor. So here we have to go for the memory. This is very important. This is the software point of view, it is a very important, because of here RAM is there. RAM is nothing but random access memory. Random access memory is nothing but whenever we have to give the some instruction to the microprocessor and microcontroller, because of suppose we have to write the any program. programming. Suppose we have to implement the pressure sensor or temperature sensor. We have to write the temperature sensor related to the C programming language is there. Where you can store the memory? So in that case, we have to go for the RAM. So random access memory. Random access memory is a storing element. Whenever we have to give the some instruction to the your microprocessor or microcontroller by using RAM. Suppose okay, how to read the data from your microprocessor or microcontroller? So we have to prefer the RAM. Or how to read the memory from the microcontroller? In that case, we have to go for the ROM. That is the read only memory. So in that case, we have to consider the read only memory. So next one is the DTA converter. Finally, we can getting whatever the digital is there, the digital value will be converted to the analog value. So this is the microprocessor or microcontroller. Especially microcontroller is the embedded microcontroller is the main heart of the embedded systems. So because of without microcontroller we can't do anything here. So that's why microcontroller or microprocessor is the main heart of the embedded system. So in that case, then here we have to processing the whatever the information will be there, whatever the programming code is there, that programming code will be processing here, then it will be given to the DTA converter, that is digital to analog converter. Finally, we can getting the actuator. This is the output side, we have to give the actuator. So here we have to get the final temperature values or pressure values. So this is the main block diagram of embedded system. The concept of embedded system is very important because of here we have to discuss about the IoT. IoT is nothing but Internet of Things, Internet of every devices, Internet of everywhere. That means by using internet we have to connecting to the many devices to the system. So in that case we have to go for the IoT. So that means IoT is nothing but it is also consisting of the hardware and software. So that's why before we going for this topic we must know about the basic fundamental of embedded system. So means embedded system it will be consisting of the hardware and software. At the same time this hardware and software will be implemented in the IoT. So that's why we have to discuss about this block diagram. Let us go for discuss about the basic software component of embedded systems. What are the software components we have to take the embedded system? So generally in embedded system software components is there. Software components of embedded systems. Software components of embedded systems. So first one we have to take the hardware. So this is the basic block. And then hardware block, next we have to go for the kernel. So next block is, this is API. So next block is, this is user. So what are the software components are required in the embedded system? Let us discuss this one. First one is the user. This one is the API, next one is the kernel, next one is the hardware. Suppose we have to take the best example, this is the mobile. I am the user, I am communicating with the mobile. How to communicating with the mobile? So first of all, I am the user, this is the user. Okay, next one is the API is there. API is nothing but application programming interface. How to interacting with the operating system? So how to interacting with the your suppose gallery is there, how to interacting with the gallery, suppose how camera is there, how to interacting with the camera. So in that case all the inbuilt API programs will be down, building file will be in the your mobile phones. So that is the very important. So how here the API will be communicating with the next block is the OS. This is the very important. So API is communicating the OS. Suppose your mobile is there. So this mobile consisting of the different kinds of softwares. Suppose we have to take the Redmi phone, we have to the operating system the Android phone. Suppose we have to go for the iPhone, it will be Apple for iPhones, it will be the operating system is the iOS. And every devices, depending upon the different operating systems. So by using operating system, we have to interacting with the hardware. So in between we can go for the kernel is there. Kernel is the very important because of your OS is not directly communicating with the hardware. In between kernel option is there. Suppose you have to go for the your mobile phone setting option is there. In that your kernel version is there. That kernel is interrelated to the communicating with the OS to hardware. And whenever the operating system is here, okay, you are communicating with the user is communicating with the hardware. Otherwise, we cannot communicating with the hardware because of this is the very important scope of software applications. So this is the best example of embedded system because of every this device will be consisting of the hardware and software components. Because of hardware is the processor will be there. So already you have to go for the setting and search setting option is there. You can search that is the processor is there, octa-core processor. Okay. Some specifications will be there, all those will be included in the your mobile phones in setting options. So about phone, you can go for the about phone, also we have to go for the all those details. So that is the main important scope. So in that case, we have to go for the software components of embedded system is very important in the embedded system design. So next one, we have to go for the hardware components. So hardware components already we have to discuss in block diagram. So sensors, A to D converters, and next one is the DTA converters and power supply. Suppose we have to take the power supply. Power supply, what are the main blocks of power supply? Power supply will be consisting of the transformer, rectifier, and next one is the filters, and next one is the stabilizers. All those are the hardware components. So that all those we have to consider the hardware components in embedded system. Basically, this means embedded system is a combination of and hardware and software. Okay, this is the complete overview of embedded system. Okay, this complete embedded system will be implemented in the IoT. So this is the Internet of Things. Internet of Things is nothing but Internet of Things is a system of computer machines, mechanical machines, and digital devices are connected to the unique ID with data transfer over it without human beings. This is the exact definition of IoT because of the by the name itself is there, by the name itself, Internet of Things. Okay, Internet of Things, things is nothing but it is a devices. So many devices is there. So many devices will be connected to the internet. So that will be calling as a Internet of Things. Let us discuss about the what are the main characteristics of the IoT. So that is the very important. What are the main characteristics of IoT? Okay, main characteristics of IoT. Here the first characteristic is the connectivity. So this is the very important connectivity. So how to connect the devices to internet? So that is the very important. In that connectivity is very important. So here we have to take the this is the IoT is there. So this is the different things will be there. It thinks it is like it is a different devices will be there. So how to connecting these devices to the internet? So this is the very important characteristic of connectivity. So this is the IoT is there. So this is the main IoT is nothing but here we have to take the IoT gateway or IoT hubs. So number of devices will be there. Suppose in embedded system we have to take the sensors. So in that sensors we have to take the suppose video sensors, suppose pressure sensor will be there, temperature sensors will be there, next one is the so different kinds of sensors will be there. So how to connecting the IoT? So in that case we have to by using how to connecting we have to use go for the USB host and next one is the Ethernet. So this is a very important because of without USB devices we cannot connect it to the another device. So because of so suppose you have to download the file from PC to your mobile, how to download the PC to videos PC to your mobile? Compulsory you have to take the USB device. Okay, USB cable is there, you have to put the PC. Okay, then you can download the options from mobile to PC, PC to mobile. All those are is communicating with the USB. So that is the interconnectivity is there. Without interconnectivity we are not communicating with the IoT. Next one is the Ethernet. Ethernet is nothing but the internet will be completely running on the Ethernet because of Ethernet is nothing but it is a network connectivity. So network connectivity, in that case we have to go for the IoT. So this is the main concept of connectivity. This connectivity is the main characteristics of IoT. So this is the first thing, and second one we have to prepare the safety. Safety. So safety is very important because of we have to communicating with the internet. So nowadays cyber crimes will be there. So cyber crimes is nothing but here cyber crimes is nothing but we have to lose the some data from the our mobiles. So how to lose the data from losses because of using internet. So that internet we have to secure purpose. So in that case we have to go for the safety. How to safety your internet by using IP. IP protocols. Internet protocols. So this will be IP call protocols. Internet protocols we have to use here. So in that case, by using this internet protocols, we have to secure the information from the anywhere. So that is also one of the main characteristics of IoT. And third one is dynamic change. So dynamic change. So fourth one is interrelated services. These all those are the main characteristics of the IoT. So dynamic change, we have to suppose we can go for the cloud computing. Also we have to change the different client to server technology will be there. In that case we have to send the data from client to server. In that case we have to go for the dynamic change. Interrelated services is nothing but all those devices are internally communicating with the internet of things. So in that case we have to go for the interrelated services. These all are the main characteristics of IoT. So that's why we have to prefer the IoT in a present technology in the entire world. So let us discuss about the physical design of IoT. Next topic is the physical design of IoT. So IoT, how does it work? What are the physical components we have to require in the IoT application? So let us discuss about the IoT. The first block is the connectivity. Connectivity, just before we have to discuss about this one. So connectivity here we have to take what are the requirements. USB host already we have to discuss, and next one is the Ethernet. So this is the very important in the IoT block, and next one is processor. So this processor is the heart of the IoT because of here we have to go for the processor. Already we have to discuss in embedded system. In embedded system we have to use the microprocessor or microcontroller. So microprocessor or microcontroller is nothing but here this is the microprocessor or microcontroller we have to take, but here processor we can consider as a CPU. CPU is nothing but central processing unit. It is the heart of the system. What are the functions of CPU? By the name itself, it performs the arithmetic and logical functions. So arithmetic and logical functions, it is like addition, subtraction, multiplication, etc. All functions will be done by using the processor. So in that case, we have to go for the processor is also very important block in the IoT, physical design. And next section is the audio video section. So suppose we have to connect the audio video section to your device. How to connect the audio and video section? So by using HDMI port. So So this is very important. So because of you have to run the, okay, suppose your mobile phone will be there, how to connect the audio video devices to the your PC. So compulsory we have to go for the HDMI port will be there. So this is the high definition multimedia interface. This is the interfacing purpose. We have to go for the audio video purpose because of PC is there, mobile is there. So our mobile phone gallery photos will be shifted to the this one. How to communicating with one? So easily we have to go for the some interfacing devices will be there. So all those will be by using HDMI port. So and next one, next one is the memory. Already previous discussed in embedded systems memory. So in memory RAM, ROM is there. So here we have to also save memory. In that memory we have to go for the NAND NOR memory. So NAND NOR memory, so this is completely related to the VLSI design. So in that VLSI design we have to go for the some memory structures will be there. In that case we have to go for the NAND NOR functionality will be there. By using NAND NOR, so we have to designing the memory structure. So in that case in memory option NAND NOR we have to use the one of the memory function. And next one is the DDR. So this one is the double data rate. So this is also one of the main memory of the IoT system. Next one is the serial data input output. How the serial data is communicated, how the serial data input output communicating with the IoT. So in that case we have to go for the interfacing devices will be there. So in that interfacing devices we have to consider the, so here interfacing devices we have to consider the, so SPI, okay, this is the one thing. So serial peripheral interface. And next one is the UART, universal asynchronous receiver transmitter. So this is I2C, inter integrated circuit. So next one is the CAN, okay, control area network. So how to communicating with the data from your device. So in that case we have to go for the serial data input output. All those interfacing device will be performing the serial communication data, because of all those are used for the short distance communication. Okay, all those devices are used for the short distance communication. So SPI and UART, I2C, CAN, because of this is completely related to the serial data input output. So and next one is the GPU. So GPU is nothing but graphical processing unit. So graphical processing unit is nothing but, suppose in IoT based we have to go for the, suppose our videos will be 2D, 3D dimensions will be there. How to collect the videos from the 2D and 3D videos. So by using graphical processing unit we have to processing of your videos from 2D converted to the 2D and 3D. So in that case we have to go for the graphical processing unit will be used in the IoT. So here especially used for the graphical cards. So the graphical cards will be acting like a graphical processing unit. So in that case we have to especially used for the graphical cards. So let us discuss about the individual functionality. This is the very important, because of in IoT based especially main application, in IoT application especially we have to use the SPI device. So what are the scope of SPI device? So how to it will be work, let us discuss about this one. SPI. Okay, so this is the very important SPI, serial peripheral interface. By the name itself, interfacing device. Okay, this is the interface. So interfacing device, how the device will be communicating with the internet. So basic, we can go for this topic. We must know about the basic fundamental and block diagram of SPI. So here we have to go for the first one is the clock signal, and next one is the serial input output data. Serial input serial data input output, and next one is the slave select. So this is, suppose we have to go for the, this is the microcontroller or microprocessor. So because of this is the, it will be acting like a master mode. It is like a master mode. Master mode is nothing but, okay, this is given to the some instruction to the slave modes. So because this is the main function, suppose here we have to go for the different types of slaves will be there. This is slave 1, okay, this is the slave 2, this is the slave 3. So these devices are connected to the all those, okay, these parameters. So this one, okay, this one, okay, this one, again this one, okay, again this one, this one, again so this is the interconnectivity of SPI mode. So this is the master mode. Master mode is nothing but, suppose we have to take the microcontroller or microprocessor, so in we have to take the one applications. I will take the best example, Raspberry Pi. Raspberry Pi. So this is the Raspberry Pi is a one of the system on chip design. So this is completely related to the embedded system, system on chip design, because of all devices inbuilt into the system. Suppose here multimedia card is there, here USB port is there, here SD card is there, here double EEPROM is there. So these, all those are the slave modes. So this is the main device, is the master mode. Here the processor will be there. So according to processor is nothing but, we have to give the some instruction to the different slave modes. So according to processor, this all those devices will be working, because under the condition of processor, okay, slave mode will be working. So in that case we have to go for the, okay, processing operation will be done in the only microcontroller or microprocessor. It will be acting like a master mode. So because of this one, especially used for the short distance communication, we have to go for the serial peripheral interface. So this SPI will be implemented in the Raspberry Pi boards. Raspberry Pi board is a system on chip device. So because of, we have to go for the our third unit in Internet of Things, third unit Raspberry Pi programming is there. Raspberry Pi programming is nothing but, suppose we have to take the Raspberry Pi boards, okay, how to download the software. Suppose one operating system is there, okay, one operating system is there, how to download the software in PC, and how to download the file will be dumping into the Raspberry Pi board. So in between we have to go for the one SD card is there. So that SD card, we have to store the memory, whatever the download file will be there, the download file will be stored in the SD card. The SD card will be taken and inserted to the your Raspberry Pi board. So the entire, so we have to connect the serial communication by using SD ports. We have to get the some Windows application by using Raspberry Pi. So this is the main feature of Raspberry Pi boards. Nowadays in IoT based application, all those are the using the Raspberry Pi boards. So this is the very important scope of Raspberry Pi boards. Okay, this is the one of the main application of SPI, serial peripheral interface. So another topic, let us discuss about the hardware components. hardware components because of in IoT we have to especially used for the hardware components. So in that case we have to go for the simple one. Block diagram is there. So generally let us discuss about the this is the hardware components of embedded system because of we have to take the Raspberry Pi. So in Raspberry Pi board different types of hardware components will be there. That hardware components it looks like this one. So in basically we have to go for the power supply, reset, oscillatory circuit, and next one is the timers, processor, serial data communication, program memory, data memory, parallel communication, and next one is the input output devices interfacing, and specified application will be there because of embedded system is a combination of hardware and software which makes dedicated for the specific application. So in that case we have to go for the specific application is there. How to run the all hardware components, let us discuss each one. So first one is the power supply. So generally our devices will be working on the power supply. Without power supply we can't do anything. So because of the devices is completely related to the power supply. So and next one is the reset. This power supply will be consisting of, just now discussed, this power supply will be consisting of the first one is the transformer, okay, next one is the rectifier, and next one is the filter, and next one is the stabilizer. This is the output, this is the AC input. So this is the general power supply block diagram. First the AC input is given to the transformer. So the transformer here we have to go for the step up, step down will be there. According to requirement we have to use the step down or step down. So then it is given to the rectifier. Already we know that the EDC subject in second year ECE. So EDC lo generally rectifier is nothing but which converts AC into DC voltage. Finally here the we are not getting the exact DC voltage. So rectifier output is the pulsating DC, so we cannot get the exact pure DC value. So in that case we have to go for the filter option is there. Filter is nothing but by the name itself we are removing the unwanted components. So in that case we have to go for the filter, we have to remove the unwanted components, we have to get the exact DC value. So that DC value is given to the stabilizer. In that stabilizer we have to maintain the constant output voltage. This is the simple block diagram of power supply. Because of in any IoT, in any embedded system application, first of all we have to go for the power supply. Without power supply, okay, your device is not working. So in that case in power supply it will be consisting of the different kinds of these blocks is there. And next one is the reset. So reset is also very important. Reset is nothing but suppose we have to write the some program in your device. you have to write the some program in your board. So we have to write the another program. Okay, how to write the another program? Suppose you have to press the reset button on board. Okay, the entire whole system will be reset. When you press the reset button, the whole system will be reset. Suppose you can take your mobile phones. Okay, suppose your mobile will be stuck is there. Sometimes stuck happen. So what you can do? Simply you can go for the reboot option is there. So when you have to press the reboot button, the whole entire system will be reset. So that purpose we have to go for the reset application. And next one is the oscillatory circuit. Oscillatory circuit is nothing but here we have to continue giving the clock signal because of already just now discuss SPI, serial peripheral interface. In SPI, the first connection is the clock signal. So SIDO, okay, serial input I did. So how the clock signal, where the clock signal will be comes from? So the clock signal will be comes from the oscillatory circuit. So that is the very important. And next one, so this is the general block diagram of power supply, reset and oscillatory circuit. Power supply, it will be consisting of all those components. And next one is the reset is nothing but when you can press the reset button, the whole system will be reset. Oscillatory circuit, we have to generating the clock signals to the your processor. Otherwise, okay, the processing will be not done. So in that case, we have to go for the oscillatory circuit. And next one is the timers and counters. So this is the timers and counters is the very important. Suppose you can go for the any traffic lights. So you can go for on the road, the traffic lights will be there. So that is the red and yellow and green. So how to will be, it will be set the 60 seconds. Okay, this 60 seconds how to will be set? Okay, you manually we cannot operate, it is automatically operated. So this is completely depending upon the timers and counter. We have to set the timer and we have to set the counting. So we have to set the 60 second is the time. Okay, we have to count the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 up to 60 okay pulses. So that will be depending on the timers and counters. And next one, processor. Already we have to discuss about the this processor in embedded system block diagram, as well as the IoT physical diagram. So processor is the main heart of the system, because of without processor we can't do anything, because of the complete program will be running on the processor. And next one is the serial data communication. So serial data communication is nothing but we have to send the data from the okay memory. See, we can go for the RS-232 cable is there. So this is the recommended standard 232 cable. By using this one, we have to send the serial data to the your device. So in that case, we have to send the data serially from your device to another device. That will be calling as a serial data communication. And next one is the program memory. Program memory is nothing but generally already we have to discuss about the memory. RAM, ROM is there. Program memory is nothing but suppose you have to write the any program into the okay your RAM. So that program, suppose this is the program, is nothing but set of instructions. So we have to give the set of instructions. So how, suppose is nothing but we have to one by one we have to give the set of instruction to the your memory. In that case, program memory is there, data memory is there. Data memory is nothing but suppose okay your processor is there, your processor data will be converted to the hexadecimal, because of before we going for this communicate data memory, we must know about the digital electronics. So the digital electronics, the first topic is the conversions is there. Okay, binary to decimal, decimal to binary, octa to decimal. Okay, all the solution. Finally, we have to convert the hexadecimal. So hexadecimal is the very important, because the here processor is there. This processor here we have to take the suppose XC86 processor is there. XC86 processor is there because of in IoT based application we have to take the XC86 servers. Okay, XC86 servers we have to consider. So XC86 servers, how the data will be converted? So the data memory is very important, because of this XC86 8086 is a 16 bit microprocessor. Okay, 8086 processor, 8086 is a 16 bit microprocessor. Already we go for digital electronics. We know that the digital electronics best. I will give the some clarity to this one. So suppose in digital electronics we have to consider the 0 or 1 okay bit, okay, and next one 4 bits, okay, this will be calling as a nibble. Okay, next one 8 bits, this will be calling as a 1 byte. So here we have to take the numbers, okay, 0 or 1 bit, 4 bits is the nibble, 8 bits is the 1 byte. So we have to go for the here, 4 bit is there, okay, next to 4 plus 4, 8, okay, 8 plus 8, okay, 16. Okay, 16. So this is the 16-bit processor. So 16 into 16 to 32, 32 into 64, 128. So according to this based processor will be designed. So this is the very important. So this will be implemented. How to design this one? Suppose this 1 byte, 2 byte, 3 byte will be there. Here the hexadecimal data will be came. Because of hexadecimal data is completely related to the assembly language. Okay, because of we have to go for the some KIL tools in embedded system IoT based application, we have to go for the some environmental tools is there. So in IoT based in embedded system some we have to go for the KIL version tools will be there. So KIL version, how to write the program, suppose we have to write the some program and we can compiling the your program and compiling that directly it will be not take the your output value, but whatever you have to given the C programming, because of C you have to given the C programming, that C program will be converted to the assembly programming because of ASM is there. Okay, assembler is there. So this is also very important because of high level language is there. Suppose C++, we have to write the some program to C++, that will be converted to the machine level language, that machine level language will be converted to the assembly level language. So that some sequence is there, okay, machine level language, assembly level language, machine high level language, machine level language, and assembly level language, okay, tarvata low level language, that is completely related to the hardware. So because of your hardware can be understood only binary format, because of 0 or 1, this is the very important scope, because of this based on your processor will be working. So because of the data memory is also related to the this one. Okay, these all those are the bits is the your data concepts. Okay, next one is the parallel communication. So this parallel communication is nothing but suppose your PC is there. Your PC data is communicating with the printer. So suppose here your PC is there. Okay, here your printer is there. Okay, you can print the one page. So what you can do, you have to connect the one parallel communication, that is a printer cable. Okay, printer cable. This printer cable will be acting like a parallel communication. So parallel communication is also very important. And next one is the input devices and output devices. So input output devices interfacing. This is very important because of here we have to go for the device manager. Because of every device will be having the drivers will be there. Suppose in mobile you have to take the CAM is there. CAM drivers is there, audio is there, audio drivers is there, video is there, video drivers is there. So many things will be there. Suppose Wi-Fi is there, Wi-Fi driver is there. So completely it is related to the drivers, okay? Because of device manager is there. Device manager is completely related to the, suppose we have to take the IoT, different devices is there. So different devices will be connected to the internet, but in before we can go further, every driver will be updated. So otherwise it will be not communicating with the internet of things. So that case we have to go for the input output devices and interfacing, and input output devices and interfacing is nothing but drivers. So drivers is the main important role in the embedded system application. So all those applications will be considered in the hardware and hardware components in embedded system. This is also one of the important scope of internet of things, because of we have to go for the in third unit Raspberry Pi is there. So the Raspberry Pi, okay, Raspberry Pi, all those components will be considered. Okay, thank you.